Thank you very much, Paul, for joining and taking out your valuable time. So this is our fourth boot camp in this series, and our today's topic is horticulture. So entrepreneurship opportunities in horticulture sector. That the whole we'll discuss today. To give you a brief info about myself, I'll be your host and presenter for this session. And my background, I'm an incubation manager at Anand Agriculture University, at Agri and Food Business Incubator. I myself was a founder of two successful startups, and I have more than 16 years of experience in banking and entrepreneurship domain in India and UAE. And I try to give my feedbacks and my experiences to the new startups and budding entrepreneurs to help them grow faster at this particular level and mentor them so they don't get carried away in that way, and they can be totally focused on their startup journey. So we'll start our session now, and this is our agenda for the day. So we'll discuss in brief what is horticulture, what are the current trends and opportunities, and few successful startup stories, and basics about the agripreneurship programs of our incubation center, and an overview of our startup ecosystem in India. And in the end of the session, we'll try to take as many questions as we can and try to guide you that how to go forward from this point and how to take benefit out of our programs. So let's start. I'll start with the basic idea of horticulture. So the term horticulture, it literally means culture of a garden. It's a Latin word where the horti means the garden, and the culture of the garden is horticulture. This is a basic idea. But in the current perspective, when we see that it's not limited to the garden, it is a whole large segment of the agriculture. In pure definition way, we can say that horticulture is an art, science, and technology and business of growing plants, various types of plants within the agriculture sector. So it is defined as a horticulture sector. So where we are currently right now, that we'll discuss what is covered in the horticulture, the branch of agriculture. So generally, broader area covers that fruit crops, vegetable crops, potato, onions, carrots and other tuber crops, medicinal herbs, aromatic plants, ornamental flower plants, spices and plantations, and recent additions in this sector, we can say mushrooms, bamboos and beekeeping, even honey is included under the horticulture sector as a whole when we are discussing it. So in this particular sector, the wide range of opportunities are there for a startup point of view. And why that opportunities are there, what is the base we have in our country? As we know that India is, one of the largest producer of the fruits and vegetables. It's if you take in the number that after China, we are after China only, that it is the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables. There are some of the fruits where we are the top producer of the world. These are the seven fruits which are, we are the top producer in, that banana, mango, guava, lemon, jackfruit, which is also making many headlines now for the past few years, and pomegranate. So we are the largest and top producer of these seven fruits. We are the number one consumer and exporter of spices. We know the spices story goes back to Vedic times, and even the occupation by foreign forces was one of the reason of our the fertile soil and the production of spices, behind which the Britishers and other foreigners came to our country in search of the same. So it is one of the reasons that we are the one of the largest producer and consumer of spices. So within this sector, as I said, agricultural sector, we say the contribution of GDP. You know, in India's agriculture GDP, more than 30% is contributed by this horticulture sector as a whole, and that. But still, it is contributing more than 30%, more than double if you compare it to the normal crops which we are using or which we are growing. So we can see the impact. You know, the less land and higher produce, which gives us the opportunity to export more, grow more. And there are, if you're a normal person's point of view, there are many nutritional benefits in the horticulture the crops compared to the normal greens and corn. So if we see the horticulture crops production in millions, by if you divide it by the state wise, so the highest biggest producer is Uttar Pradesh, and with 24% of production happening from Uttar Pradesh state itself, and we are at I think fourth position there with 8% of total produce happening in Gujarat, and other states are I think somewhat nearby. So Uttar Pradesh and some other states are doing fairly well because of the land area and the previous practices they have in that particular sector. So if we look into our import export parameters and the figures of top fresh foods and vegetable produce going out of India and coming to India, so the largest produce are, you know, if you see exports, onion is carrying the highest contribution in the export side. Imports, we are importing many fruits from outside, like, you know, apples, dates, raisins, oranges, pears, kiwi fruits, and other dried fruits, even grapes and other things we are importing from outside. So and exports also we have a similar number of, but when we look at the import part from a startup's point of view, there is an opportunity there. If we can contribute and reduce the import of the particular products, and if we can find some ways to process and produce and grow this kind of crops in our own country, then we can contribute largely in that particular segment with the help of that. So we understood that there, it is fairly well-versed industry within our country, and we are doing fairly well in terms of being one of the largest producer of the horticultural crops and food and vegetables. But what are the major issues and challenges are there? As I said, and I'm repeating it in our all sessions, that a startup should find opportunities and ideas from the problems of the industry. So the horticulture industry as a whole, what are the problems and challenges right now people are facing? The first problem which we can identify, that inappropriate, inadequate cold storages. You know, there are, if we see the bigger picture, because of the inadequate transport facility and cold storages, we are losing a lot of, our post-harvest loss in vegetables and food sector, it's worth more than 2 lakh crore each year. You know, it's a huge number. Over 30% of vegetable lies unharvested, you know, due to the acute sort of labor, inadequate cold storage and transportation facilities. Also, one of the reason behind it in overall, and from consumer point of view, people are losing faith in the, you know, the crops which we do, the instances where we, you know, have that heavy metal toxicity found in the vegetables and other food products. So how, these are the all problems which the industry as a whole is facing, and which is creating an opportunity for us. So growth in horticulture, what is the scope of growth if you say? So I believe that Indian horticulture is at a point where, you know, indeed Indian dairy was a decade ago. If we discussed the dairy industry yesterday, and it is at a tipping point where the growth is, you know, it can be a very high growth producing sector. Horticulture will lead an agri-food tech investment in next decade in India. These are the predictions by various investors in this sector. And opportunities are coming, you know, the overall, if you look at the global picture, that 70% right now, the number is around 50%, 55% population is living in urban cities. And the other part is in the rural area. Globally, by 2050, the population growth in urban cities are likely to increase, you know, at a very high level. There are some surveys which are indicating a number of 70%, which is very high. So there is an opportunity where a startup can target an urban class population with the this horticultural crop produces a fruit and vegetables market and reach at a growth and profitable stage by targeting them. In terms of the production capacity, we are largest producer, but compared to our per capita availability of fruit, which is, you know, less than recommended quantity of through 230 gram per day. So that if with increasing produce and increasing food processing capabilities, we can target that particular segment. There are other opportunities of, as I said, that the problems are there for inadequate cold storages. It creates an opportunity for a small size cold storages, creating startups which can create multiple storages houses at village and rural level clusters. And the shelf life of the fruits and vegetable can be increased, you know, by twofold. I guess it can, if it is increasing by a few days, also it gives a lot of immense value to the grower and the farmer itself. Innovative planting material requirements, that as the trend is growing, that people are looking into that particular sector. Even non-farmers are also coming in that particular sector. So innovative farming material startups can also grow. There are multiple startups already working in that particular segment where we are trying to, you know, find some cheaper and innovative planting materials. The food processing sector is also, there is a huge opportunity there. There are, as I mentioned, there are a lot of post-harvest losses. It's worth, you know, 2 lakh crore in India itself. So if we found rural possibilities where rural level clusters where we can create a food processing units there and process the crops at a local level or at a regional level in that particular area, that there is an opportunity for startups in that particular area there. Vertical farming and with by various methods like hydroponic and aquaponics methods are growing at you know, very high stage right now. We will discuss in detail that particular sector in our next segment of our presentation. And farm to fork platforms, the platforms where, you know, they are trying to create and replicate and trace the whole produce from a seed to it's reaching to the plate of a consumer. There are many platforms which are directly buying you know, items and goods from the local grower or farmer and selling it to directly to the consumer itself, maintaining the whole supply chain and removing middlemen and giving them assurance of quality products. And the third, which is already organic farming, is the trend and opportunity which is growing very, you know, very high growth rate. And compared to after the COVID-19 situation which we are in, the demand for organic and good quality, high nutritional foods and vegetables and fruits are growing at a very high stage, at a very high level. So these are the opportunities. The main opportunity I wanted to highlight, many startups are growing. The focus was on urban farming. So the urban farming includes, as I mentioned, various methods where in the city area and heavy populated area, the farmer or even the residents are growing their food in their terraces, and the trend is increasing at a very high level. The global market by 2023 is expected to reach at 236 billion for urban farming. And it is very, very big market. The basic idea is producing food in a city or within the municipality to remove the problems of tracing the food plus the transport issues and giving the freshest possible produce to the consumer. That's why this trend is going up. One of the part and one of the best possibility, or you can say the technology which is there, growing, and this is a practice of growing crops vertically. So it's called vertical farming. The global market is expected to reach 12.4 billion by 2036. Globally, this trend is going very high, where in a controlled environment agriculture, which aims to plant growth and soil-less farming techniques such as hydroponics and aquaponics, which can, within less soil, with the use of less soil and less water in a controlled environment, which is, removing all the hurdles which weather is giving us, fruits and vegetables can grow in an indoor or outdoor, outdoor premises where everything can be controlled. So the hydroponics and aquaponics and other methods are playing a big role in achieving this thing. The global growth rate, till 2026, it is expected to grow at 24.8%, which was never there before. This is a huge growth rate. There is a huge possibility for all startups, from the manufacturer of the equipment to the growers and farmers, urban farmers. There is a huge opportunity in this particular sector. So what if, as I mentioned, the current, if I say the last figure of 2018, the global vertical farming figure was that 2.3 billion. It is expected to reach around 12 billion, which is, if you see in the number within the next 6, 7, 8 years, it will grow, like sixfold. There is a huge possibility there. Irrigation systems growth, this kind of systems growth will increase at a large scale, if you can see the normal level. So this whole vertical farming methods, there are a few practices which are very popular right now. The one of the practices is hydroponic. So hydroponic, what is hydroponic? Hydroponic is a form of gardening that uses no soil, but instead grow plants in a solution and water-based solution of water with added nutrients. So what happens in hydroponics, I think you all are aware of what's happening in hydroponics. Without soil, with very less soil or the substitutes which we can get for soil like cocopeat and all, the very less soil, the plants are grown in a indoor or outdoor environment where additional nutritions are added, and the trend is growing like anything. There are multiple ways within the hydroponic systems which we can utilize. There is a drip based system, there is a water flow based system, floating root system, and aeroponic system. There are multiple technologies and methods which we can discuss in detail in future sessions. But here I wanted to give you an highlight that what startups are doing right now in the particular sector. So when we are looking at this sector, the next method which is getting very popular is aquaponics. aquaponic is a combination of aquaculture, which you know, which is growing fish and other aquatic animals, and hydroponics, which is growing plants without soil. So what happens in the system that, you know, the biggest drawback, if I can say, minus point of a hydroponic system, which we discussed earlier, that we have to add nutrients into the soil, into the water, sorry, this is soilless farming. So we have to add very nutrients into the water, and the solutions which are coming, which are there in the market, is very costly. So what is the solution then? The solution is that creating a whole ecosystem. This is just replicating the nature, you know. So though when it is the whole hydroponic system is connected with a fish pot or a pond of fish, where you know the ammonia and even the remains of the fish, it is given to the same water is given to the plants, and plant is creating this bacteria from the plants is creating the ammonia, transferring ammonia into the nitrate, and the whole ecosystem is working in its own and creating a solution for us with a good low cost hydroponic system. So why this is important? This is very, this becomes, of course, hydroponic and this all things were growing at a slower pace since past many years. But the recent trends and the grow your own food movement, which is already happening across the world and which was fueled by the COVID-19 situation. People got a lot of time at their home and they wanted to eat healthy as much as possible. So it fueled this grower and your own food movement, and the objective was that, you know, people take delight in more wholesome, fresh, chemical free tasty food. You know, they don't want to eat anymore that weeks old storage house repeat produce, which is you know, tainted with the insecticide and weed killers at a large. So people are afraid, they want to be healthy. That's why the grow your own food is this movement is growing, and a startup can take benefit out of it and ride the wave and grow further in it. So if I want to show the some of the successful startup in that particular area, one startup which you know which is becoming very famous recently, and it was trending in social media also, the startup name is Urban Kishan. So what Urban Kishan does is they build vertical farms in India and sell their produce directly to the consumer via an app. There is an app called Urban Kishan where you can subscribe for everyday delivery of your fresh vegetables, which is grown in their farms. And second part of their business is they built a small size family home kit where you know the people can buy that particular kit and grow your own food, which was, you know, which got a very good response from a lot of people, and eventually it was represented many film celebrities and personalities adopted it organically, and then it started becoming a trend in the particular region. The startup was successful of raising their own seed fund of $1.5 million, and it is growing at a very high growth rate right now. So they are riding the wave, the same thing which I mentioned in hydroponic. If I don't use any methods or technologies, people still want to grow their own food and plants and other herbs at their home. The proof of it is this startup. It is name is Ugao.com. So Ugao.com is all green online portal which you know caters all gardening farming needs of a community people who want to build their own or grow their own food and plants. So the startup grown like anything, and they raised, this was the first startup I think which became so big in the particular horticulture sector, where they are connecting multiple people who are interested in the particular product, and they also created a subscription based model where they are sending boxes every month or every period to you, and normal people are planting that particular seeds or plants. The biggest thing they were able to achieve, that you know, when you buy a plant from a nursery or a local level, when it reaches to your home, because of the packing issues, the transport cannot be very long. But they mastered the art of packing live plants and sending it to you guys. And because of which they were able to raise a $30 million worth of funding from the market, and they are growing and introducing more than 50-60 plants every few months, and finding new plants and finding ways to send it to the people. This is riding on the same wave of grow your own food or do it yourself concept. The founder of the startup name is Siddharth, and he was very successful. The startup is barely 4 years old. It was launched in 2016, and within that particular period, they became so grand. So it can be a motivation for you guys when you plan to start something new. There is an opportunity if you look at the same thing in a if you try to find ways and ideas from the problems which people are facing. Another startup is based in Australia. The name is Local Seed. It's a market where it's for local seeds. People who want to save their seeds, the organic seeds, which are natural to their particular area, and they don't want to go into the hybrid GMO seed-based movement where people are not sure what they are eating. So this is a marketplace where people, local buyers and sellers are selling, meeting and selling their own seeds. This is also getting a lot of traction globally. It's not there in India till now, but globally, this is a successful startup based in Australia. You can take opportunity from the mindset which became because of the behavioral practices change after the COVID-19 situations. There is a huge opportunity there. Second opportunity is IoT based, as I mentioned last time. Technology is making its way in all the sectors. So famously I call it is the Internet of Plants. So what is it? It basically enables growers to remotely monitor their crop over a network with the help of various IoT devices, which can help grow their produce better, which can alter light and nutrients requirements as remotely as possible, which is helping indoor farming a lot more. So this is example I took of a system, IoT device based system, which is managing water irrigation, humidity, temperature, light, soil, view, everything with the sensors and various devices. They create a whole ecosystem, and the same ecosystem is giving the people the possibility to control it from a mobile device whenever they want to operate it from a far view. They don't have to be in their farm at a time. So this is gaining a lot of traction there. There are multiple startups working and using technologies like AI, IoT, and big data to create better products and try to catch on. Again, they are trying to catch on the farm to plate, food to fork, or seed to plate models. One of the successful startups is AIBino, which is using data to match demand supply synchronization, farm analytics, and everything to prevent food wastages, improve agriculture efficiency, and stabilize livelihood of farmers. At the same time, giving the confidence to the consumer that they, from the start when the seed is grown into the farm, they are tracking it from that particular point of time. And even AIBino has created multiple brands within their own startup. Some of the brands are, seed to plate restaurants chain. They are delivering the complete food to your doorstep, where everything is tracked, and they are giving you the confidence in that particular segment, what you are eating, that it is the best produce. So this particular platform is raised more than $2 million funding, and its founder name is Vivek Rajkumar, which is also recognized by multiple international platforms and awarded by there are ecosystem partners. So there is an opportunity in that app-based solutions also. As I said, farm to fork models are gaining a lot of traction. One of the other startup I wanted to highlight is the startup named Vaiku. Again, the same startup, name itself is mentioning that why you should cook. You don't need to cook because we are delivering you the whole food, ready to eat food at your doorstep, where we are producing it by ourselves in our own greenhouses, and creating the whole product and giving it to you at your doorstep. Or they are targeting basically the ready to eat on the go food segment, and they were successful to raise more than $5 million in pre-seed funding, and the startup is doing fairly well right now. So there are opportunities there. So because they are managing everything from seed to direct and product at their own end, so there are opportunities, and it gives better confidence to the consumer when they are buying a particular product. So the opportunities are on multifold. First, I highlighted you can use various technologies to create a unique ecosystem or unique products. Then there are possibilities of using internet and apps and to reach your customer. The other possibility is that novel crops for your region. So a horticultural entrepreneur can target multiple ways to get into the system. One more way is to you find new crops which you can grow in particular your region and produce some product out of it. So for example, recent trend, if you can see that the dragon fruit trend is growing. It was not our own product, but now a lot of farmers and the small farmers or horticulturalists are making their ways in that particular crop. Even government is supporting in some of the ideas of growing dragon fruit and similar kind of other products. Some mushroom varieties are there. Some of one of our startup is growing figs in this weather, So they found some ways to create some unique products. There were a cactus fruit product was there. One of our funded startup, which got funding of more than, I think, 5 lakh rupees from granting aid scheme, was making products out of this cactus fruit, which is helping people in getting their daily dose of iron and other nutritional benefits. So there is a possibility for you guys to explore in that particular area. If you find some novel crops or new novelty items which you can grow, and not only growing and developing a product out of it, an innovative product that can give you a boost and in your initial days to reach into the particular segment. The fourth sector I wanted to highlight is, as I mentioned, that there are huge post-harvest losses in India, and we cannot afford that. There is a population which is, living below poverty line. There is a requirement of saving whatever harvest we are getting already, despite of being the biggest producer of a lot of products and vegetables and fruits and spices. Still, there is a post-harvest losses problem is there, and we have to find ways to solve this problem. And one of the startups one of the solution is that solar powered mini warehouses at village levels. So some of the startup are already addressing this problem. The one startup I wanted to highlight, the name is cool crop. So what cool crop guys are doing? So these guys are creating a decentralized on-farm cold storage solution for the farmers and farmer cooperatives and local village levels or aggregators, where you know the infrastructure is backed by predictive market analytics and crop management platform which they build themselves. And they are installing this small solar power warehouses in the local village areas where few villages are or few producer of the particular vegetables and food items can store their food for few 1, 2, 3, 4 days, which can give them opportunity to get better prices for their goods and reduce the the hurry of reaching to the market. And when the transport is not available every day in that particular area or region, so it can save a lot of lot of money for the rural entrepreneurs and farmers. So this startup is doing fairly well, and they are right now even in Gujarat also. It is Maharashtra and Gujarat. They are targeting a lot of areas where they can install such systems. So there is this was an unique idea. Another unique idea, which I highlighted before also, that on farm post harvesting activity hubs should be created. If a startup can create this kind of post harvest activity hubs at village levels, so it reduces the post harvest loss chance and enhance the comfort of a person working in the particular sector or particular area. Where the similar concept was also built by our university, by College of Fruit Processing Technology and Bioenergy, and it was getting a lot of good feedback from the users. So similar kind of this is for your ideas. If you can take an idea out of it and build on it, can create a successful. Another items which I highlighted previously. A startup can the same thing. If you are not able to install cold storages, or if the cost is a little bit higher, then there are low cost evaporative cooling structure can be created and given to vegetable farmer or trader which can which don't consume energy a lot of energy, and for a short duration. Perishable products can be stored. The same things are there. The one of the opportunity or one of the idea which I mentioned last is solar powered eco-friendly food and vegetable carts for the vendors, because even at the end any vegetable or food loss is loss of our country. Now everything, if it is lost by the farmers for the post harvest or after harvest, it once is reaching to the vegetable vendor, if there is a loss, if it is not able to sell the goods in one day or two day, we have to find some unique ideas that how to we can help them to stay on it a little bit longer. So there are multiple technologies also developed by our college or many other universities. A startup can look into the ecosystem or the technologies developed by one of the technology or process developed by our college. There was a food based coating, which if you put that coating into the tomatoes or another similar kind of perishable item, it can increase the shelf life of tomatoes by few days. So similar kind of technology which is developed or which is developed in our universities or any other university or globally. A startup should find ways to how I can take that particular technology and reach it to the direct end user, farmer or consumer, and I can create an enterprise out of it. Agripreneur can be can should look into these areas where you can find some ways to identify some great concepts to benefit our system as a whole and benefit yourself. Create a system. So if you are an agripreneur, if you have an innovative idea, agribusiness idea in the harvesting horticulture sector, you can reach out to us. We have a whole ecosystem of startup, helping startup. We are running two unique programs to help young companies who are working on an innovative idea and want to bring their product or produce into the market. So if you are a startup recognized and falling under the criteria defined by the government of India, so if you have an innovative or scalable model, a private limited LLC company or an idea stage company, which is, you know, less than 10 years of age, this is a definition given by the government of India. So if you have an original entity with less than 100 crore turnover, less than 10 years of age, and innovative scalable model, you can reach out to us for the help in the in that particular area. And every startup program of ours is focusing on the innovation part. So to simplify, what is an innovation? Innovation is creating something that was not done before. So if you are creating something that is not available in our market, so you can take benefit out of it, or you can give some additional value addition to the existing produce which we have, then you can apply in our programs. As I said, the startup ecosystem in India is growing very, you know, at a very fast pace. A lot of agri startup has raised funding in last 3-4 years. Our last figure was, you know, around $300 billion was raised by around 53 startups from the market. I'm not talking about government, from the market. So it is the third largest startup ecosystem in the world. And if you can take benefit out of it, if you can grow, if you want to know how to do that, reach out to us, attend our boot camps and programs. We are running right now two different programs, as I said, to scale up your idea into a viable business. So what is the background of it? That you already completed 4 successful cohorts. As I mentioned, in the horticulture part, our few of our startups are doing fairly well. One of the funded startup, as I mentioned, that is working on the a drink, a juice out of this cactus root product, which can give value addition and additional nutritional requirements can be fulfilled of our consumer. A similar kind of startup, there are startups working in the hydroponic, improving the existing hydroponic systems are also part of our last cohort of 4th cohort. And more than 50 such entrepreneurs and agripreneurs are already graduated from our program. So right now we are inviting application from our 5th cohort, where we are running 2 programs. Our first program is name is Pallav. It's an agripreneurship orientation program. It is ideally for the students and agripreneurs who has an idea but don't have a product or knowledge to take that idea and make it to the market. So if you have an innovative idea, you can apply for Pallav program. It is a 2-month comprehensive training program. And after completion of the training program, a startup can apply for a grant in aid of up to 5 lakh rupees in our RKVY Agri-Apprenticeship Orientation program. The same program, the second program which we are running right now is a Prashun program, Startup Agri-Apprenticeship Incubation program, where if you have already identified a product or built a product, you have already registered a company and you want to take it to the market at a scale your business, you can take advantage of this program where participant will get 2 months of comprehensive training. And after training completion, you can apply for a grant in aid up to 25 lakhs from the government. This is one of the program which, you know, which is giving you amazing opportunity, because it is not easy to raise funds when you are a startup, and getting funds and granting aid funds without giving any equity to anybody give you a lot of room and lot of that can increase your period where you can take some chances, some risk in your business without making harm of yourself or getting any harm. And you can take advantage of it is up to 25 lakh rupees. There is no such program of any other kind. It is always difficult for the startup to raise funding. Government of India already invested more than 36 crores in this program, and more than 234 agri startups are already funded under this RKVY Raftar Agri Business Incubation Scheme. And plus that scheme, plus you have an AU advantage. You know, we have a state-of-the-art incubation center in food processing, which is funded by Industries Commissioner of Government of Gujarat, which was inaugurated by our honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi in 2018, which is helping people to bring your idea and make it into a, you know, convert your idea into a product and go to the market. We have created a whole ecosystem where you come with the idea and create your own product and how to reach the market. We guide you how to reach to the market and give you possibility to raise funding and without giving you anything in return. So I think I'll wrap up the session, today's session, by at this point, and I'll open a floor for the question answer session. If any participant have any questions regarding the particular programs or even anything general in the business, please feel free to ask. We are happy to answer. Thanks a lot. I wanted to highlight one of the points that the last date of applying for the program is 28. So if you are looking into this particular sector, make sure you apply before that time. So that's all from my side. The floor is open for questions. If there is any question, please feel free to ask.
Sir, hello. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes, I'm Priyadarshini. Basically, I'm from Coimbatore. So in our area, we have lots of coconut farms. So I just explored very few things recently and I could find some export market for desiccated coconut and other related products. So I want, then I searched for like people's need towards vegan milk. So right from coconut, but the thing is now a coconut, it is its shelf life is only 10 days. But there are in Thailand, people use that vegan milk for 4 months. Its shelf life is 4 months. So if I, whether I can apply for this program, because you have mentioned about vegetables, whereas I couldn't find anything on coconut. But now I'm currently doing my PGDM from Ahmedabad EDIA. So I just explored this program and I wanted to apply. If I apply, then whether I could get some help from you. Or
yes, it's for sure. Priyadarshini, thanks. It is a very good question. And I think I should appreciate that you look into the actual problems in the area and you find a solution. This is the best way a startup can go forward. Coconut, again, it is coming another year. The program is for any agripreneur. If you are working in agriculture, horticulture, fruit items, and if you find a way if there are no solutions of similar kind available, so then I think you can surely see application. One part, you can surely apply for the program. There is no issue about it. And to increase the shelf life, we have experts of the sector. If you are within our incubation program, if you are selected, you will get opportunity to interact with them and find a solution to make your product better. And I think we can help you in that particular area. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Answer.
Sir, I have one query.
Yes.
What is the eligibility criteria to apply this incubation program? Because we are inventor, designer, developer of artificial intelligence, pest management devices or technology, you can say, for pest management, for crop protection in agriculture sector, especially. And we are developing...
So, your prototype is ready already?
Yeah. We are in early stage. Already our product has been accepted by farmer scientists. These product validated by ICAR, KVK, then ICRISAT, and already these devices purchasing.
Have you received any granting and funding already?
Sorry, pardon?
Have you your company received any granting and funding previously?
Yeah, already
from any
we
government
have
scheme?
No, not yet.
Not yet, right? Okay, then I think if your idea is innovative and if you have a product ready, you can surely apply for this. There is no specific eligibility requirement. Eligibility requirement, I mentioned that, you know, it should be a startup company with an innovative product. So we are not looking into the any other aspect. Main idea is innovation. If we have something innovative, as you mentioned, that there is an app for crop management and it is fairly innovative, if you are saying we are free to apply, just make an application on our website and we will go through the application. There is a whole selection process. So once you apply, there will be a presentation opportunity given to you. You can present it in front of the RIC committee, and then committee will decide that they will be able to accept you in the program or not. But as you mentioned and whatever you clarified, I think you are eligible to apply for the program. There is no issue about it.
And
so
one more query. I have one more query. If our startup has been selected, so what support we will get from this incubation program?
Yeah. So from incubation program point of view, again, what stage you are in? At the stage we can support you. First of all, you will get comprehensive mentoring and training. For the second, you will get an opportunity to apply for the grant in funding up to 25 lakhs or 5 lakhs, depending on the stage you are in. And as you know that Anand Agriculture University here has its own networking and market linkages. If we find your product fitting somewhere and if we get a chance to promote your product or any of our incubators startup, we'll always try and promote you guys there. So there are many benefits for you guys. So you will get a recognition that you are accepted in the prestigious incubation program, plus training, plus networking and market linkages and funding. This is the whole benefit every startup will get which is selected in our program. Yeah.
Thank you so much for your valuable guidance. Thank you.
Mentorship and facility also you can utilize from us. Yes.
So the program, I think in chat box, Vibhuti is asking that when the program is starting. So program hopefully will start in mid of May. It is 2 months program. We are yet to decide on the structure because of the COVID situation. 99% of the program will go online. So it will be online training mode. For you guys who are selected for the particular program, it will start in mid of May. Okay, the date is not final yet, but we will inform the selected participant once it's decided. Applications will close by 28th of April Sunday. So you should apply before that and wait for the question answers from the training. Any other questions, participants?
Yes, sir. If a student want to enter in the interior decorator, then what will he have to do?
Can you just, what is it? Interior decorator?
Interior decoration, yes, sir.
I think I am not able to understand. Interior decoration, has it been architects and buildings you are talking?
Yes, sir.
My focus and our focus here is on agriculture. Okay. So, if you want to go into interior decoration part, this is also out of the subject. But let me give you a simple advice in that. So, if you are already working in that particular segment or if you are taking training in that, eventually you will get there. But if you are not taking an education program or graduation in that particular field, the first idea is to go and study. There are interior decoration colleges. If you are already doing that, you will get opportunity there. If it is not there, then just do internship at any nearby famous interior decorator in your region and ask him. You will learn a lot of things when you have hands-on training. There are only two ways. Though it was out of subject, but I think that can help you in that.
it isn't fall in horticulture.
Yes. Any other questions?
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, हाइड्रोपोनिक के अंदर जो न्यूट्रिएंट सॉल्यूशन रहता है उसके अंदर जो ये लोग एनपीके डलवाते हैं तो उन न्यूट्रिएंट सॉल्यूशन को ऑर्गेनिक बोल सकते हैं कि नहीं बोल सकते?
If you are adding any fertilizer, मतलब आप अगर कोई ऐसा fertilizer additionally add कर सकते करते हो तो उसको organic नहीं बोल सकते logical, but still because it is a technical matter, it's not a, yeah it's a technical matter, we have to ask particular technical expert in that segment because legally जो आप certification के लिए जो requirement है अब वो उसकी हमको guidelines में देखना पड़ेगा. So, आप एक काम करिए, ईमेल लिख दीजिए हमारा आईडी पे, मैं वो इंडस्ट्री पर्टिकुलर सेगमेंट के एक्सपर्ट से पूछ के फिर आपको उसमें डेफिनेटिव आंसर दूंगा. प्रैक्टिकली अगर आप ऐड कर रहे हैं कोई जिसमें केमिकल यूज है, यू कैन नॉट टेल इट दैट इट इज ऑर्गेनिक, बट स्टिल इट्स अ टेक्निकल ग्रे एरिया, वी हैव टू चेक द गाइडलाइंस. सो जस्ट एक ईमेल लिख दीजिए, हम आपको ट्राई करेंगे आपको उसका आंसर आगे दे सकते.
ओके, थैंक यू सर.
Thank you. Any other questions? Okay, if there are no questions, I'll wrap up the session I'll wait for 2 more minutes if there are any questions, and if anyone wants to ask any questions. Okay, there are no questions in the chat box also. Okay. Thanks a lot. Thank you for joining. And our next session will be on 22nd. We will try to bring you opportunities from another period also. Okay, I just received another question. Let me answer that. So Viva is asking, can you let me know the daily hours of training and apart from the online mentorship, can I get access to the lab and other services? See Viva, it's a 2 months program where we will minimum we will give you a 60 hours of training. So it's not decided that every day you will get training or every day you will get selected for a particular program or every day you will have session, but the sessions will be arranged according to the when we have availability of experts. If it is a completely online session, then we have to look into the matters of daily hours. It can be different every day, so there are no fixed timings, but we'll generally try to accommodate everyone, so it will be fairly good and you will not, it will not take your whole day. Second, If it is offline mode, then we were giving to access to lab and other services of the department to everyone. And all incubatees are eligible. They can request if they have some specific requirement. But Due to COVID, we have to look into the particular time period when we can invite you here to use our facilities because of the legal restrictions, nothing else. Otherwise, all our incubatees are eligible to request for expert guidelines and lab and other facility uses, which is part of incubation center. You can still take them. Okay, so we'll try to help you in that part also.
Okay, thanks, sir.
Thank you
for the answer. Yes.
Thanks. Okay, one more question I received from Pitesh. It is going to be organized for next year also. It is a government scheme. Hopefully, if it is live for till next year, we'll try to help you in that. But if it is not there, still incubation center is there. You can ask and you can reach out to us if you have any questions related to the sector. Okay. So programs will be given on time to time basis. So whenever we have some possibility or government permissions, so then we only introduce the product, because in program has a grant-in-aid funding requirement. So it depends on the funding we receive from the government side. So next year, there is no confirmation, but hopefully it will be there. Okay. Thanks. Okay. Okay. So our time is up. Thanks a lot. We'll wrap up the session. I thank you everyone for joining and patiently being joined for the whole session. Hopefully it will be very useful for you in the longer run. I invite everyone to apply for our programs. And lastly, I would like to thank our principal and dean, Dr. R.F. Shukar and Dr. H. Pandey for the motivation and support to running this program. I also thank HERS for managing the participants. And I invite you all to join our next session on 22nd on another sector. And we'll